Hello, I'm Michal. Let's talk about the difference between store and context. Well, you know that I've made a video about how you can pass store over context to make a reactive context, right? And some of you may ask me like, what is the difference between a store and context, right? If you have a store, why do you need context? Or if you have context, why do you store, for example? So let's take a look at one example over here. Over here, I have a app which has two parents, right? Parents 1 and parents 2. These two components actually are the same. Actually they are the same, right? I just create two of them for no reason. But anyway, parents 1 imports the children. And this child component reads a context from the parents, right? The parents set a context over here called data, which is a context data. And the child reads from it, right? Get context, the context data. We pass the data that we'll pass in is actually a store. So when you read this, to get a value out of it, you use a dollar prefix syntax to read the value of the context. On the other hand also, I created a file called store.js, which imports the writable and create a writable store. And I import this to parent as well as the child. So in the parent one, I import this store data. And I have a range inputs to kind of like modify the value of the store. Same thing goes for parents too. Is the same code, right? So I have two inputs, one to modify the data of the context for this parent and modify the data of the store, which is from this store file. Parent 2 as well as the context data where it has one inputs to modify the data of the inputs and one inputs to modify the data of the store, which is coming from this file. And the child, both of them have a child, and the child component is the same component which reads imports from the store data and imports get the context from context data and show both of the value of the store. And that's it. So so let's try to play things around and see what happens, right? So if I change the value of the store right now, when I change it, you can see that all the instances that imports from this store, right? Parents 1 import from this file, parent 2 imports from this file, child imports from this file. So all of them are importing from the same store instance. And when one of these instances change the value, all the other instances actually get notified and update the value itself as well. So you can see that the store, when it changed from the parent 1, the child within parent 1 is updates as well. And the parent 2 updates as well. Updates as well. And the child within parent 2 updates as well. If I change from parent 2, same things happens, right? All of them are importing from the same store. Therefore, all of them get notified or get updated at the same time. They are all in sync. Now take a look at context, right? So for context wise, I actually create two stores, right? I create one store for the parents 1. And send it to the context. I create another store for parent 2 and send it to the context. So they are actually different store. In child, the child component is the same, where in terms of code, it is the same component file, but imported in two different places, right? Meaning where it's being imported, where it's being used, then what kind of context you'll get will be depends on where it's being used, right? So So the child is being used in parent 1 and parent 2, then respectively, they receive the context from each of their parents. So if I change the parent 1's context value, you can see that the child in context in the parent 1 get updated, but the child in parent 2 does not know at all, because it's living in a different context. It's receiving the context data from a different parent. It's receiving from these parents too. So if I change the value of the context in the parents 2, then you can see that the child in parents 2 is changing, right? But not the child, the data in the child in the parent 1, right? So now you see that there's this difference, and this is the main difference between a context and a star. Although, so the star itself, if you're using a same instance of the star, basically you can make anyone, anywhere that is using the star to be updated, to be in sync at the same time. Context, on the other hand, works is slightly different concept, right? Context says that for all the components that is within my context will receive this context, will receive the data that I'm going to pass through this context. So they can get the same data, right? So if I'm passing the same, if I create one store instance, then all of the children will get reference of that store instance. We're going to pass, if I'm going to pass this, the instance of this store from store.js, then you probably see that if I change all of the, if I pass the same store context, store instance to both the parent one and two, then you still, you will see that all the instances will be updated. That's not because they are, you are not about the context anymore. It's about the store instance, because if they're getting the same store instance, then they're gonna do it, they are gonna get updated at the same time in sync, right? But for context, it's more of where you are living under, right? In this case, we create a different content store instance, then you are living in a different context. Therefore, you get a different store instance, and therefore, if you change from parent one, only the child in the parent one will get updated. If you change from parent two, only the child, only the store instance in the store in the child in the parents two will get updated, right? So there you go. So there you see the difference between a store and a context, and they are not like mutually exclusively kind of different. Therefore, you can actually use them together. You can have a store inside a context to create a reactive store. Okay, so here is the difference between a store and a context. But some of you may still ask me, like, I know the difference, but how should I decide when should I use a store or when should I use a context? How do I differentiate when or what kind of scenarios I should use which of the things? I know how it behaves, I know how it works, but which one should I use? So here I'm going to share you a way to think about how or when you should use a store or when you should use a context or when you should use both. Okay, so imagine over here you have a 2x2 matrices, which is a 2x2 different kind of scenarios that you can encounter. So it depends on the data, right? The data you want on the x-axis, what you want is whether this data is static or this data is dynamic. So static data is something that you wouldn't expect any changes, but dynamic data is you want this to be changed during the runtime, which is during user interactions, where user interacts and you want this data to change. And on the vertical axis, on the other hand, you have what I call a global data or a local data. So for global data, it's not about how pervasive this data is being used. It's more of this data should be one and only one, right? This data should be, you should only have one data for all of the components or wherever you use it. It does not matter where you're using it. You're gonna have just one copy of the data. And for local data, it's more of where you are using it. It depends where you're using and what kind of data you're gonna get. Okay, so you have static, dynamic, and global to local. So you have a static local kind of data or static global kind of data, and you can have a dynamic local or dynamic global data. All right, so let's take a look at example, right? I've been trying to think about what is the best example for you, and I've been thinking about this and coming up with like different examples for different scenarios may not be convincing, because sometimes this example can actually be part of any kind of scenarios, right? Because for example, a team, it can be a global team, but it could still be a local team, right? Sometimes in your application, some parts of it is using like this maybe like a dark blue theme and part of it is like a dark green theme, right? You can have different kind of themes within the within your application at the same time. So theme can be a global thing. It could be a local thing. And theme itself can be fairly static. For example, you don't expect user to change the theme, but it could be fairly dynamic as well. Sometimes it allows your user to change the theme from maybe a light theme to a dark theme to a different kind of theme. Right? So depends. It really depends on your use case. It really depends on what your requirement is. Determine it. Rather than say theme should be always be like a dynamic thing or theme should always be a static thing, right? So this is exactly the example that I'll come up with. I'm going to have a data called color. Over here, let's take a look at the first scenario, a static and a global data, right? In this data.js, I have a color. So this color, I'm not going to use a star because it's static, right? So for static data, you're going to just define this variable as it is. Define it as a variable so that you can use this variable across components. So I'm using this data in a button. So in a button, I import this color and I can use it. And I also have this over here. I have like a game controller thing. So in the controller, I also, let's see, right? Oh, I think it's a game. Ah, okay. I didn't do that. So in the controller, I also import the color. Right, in the controller, I also import the color. So this color is static. I can import in multiple components and just use it, right? And it's because if it is a global thing, so I can define it in maybe like one file and everyone can just import this file and use this data, right? So static and global, right? Static means that you would not use store, and global means you don't have to use context. It does not matter where your button or where your game component is, you just use this same color. So you import from the same file. Okay. And static locals. So in this case, still color, but it depends on where the button is or where your component is. You may want to have a different color. Right. So all of this, all of the button you can see on the screen is the same component. It's this button component. So it depends on where this button resides in the component tree of your app component tree. It shows a different color. It shows a different background color. So in this case, to do that, I'm using a context, right? An easier way for me is to use a context, or I can have maybe like export as a props instead of getting it from a context, right? So props is your parents pass the data to you. Context is a parent pass data to all of you, all of the children. In this case, I'm going to use a context instead of a props because the place that sets the color is actually very high up in the component tree. In this case, it's in the app. In the app, I pass different colors to the game. I pass green and pass blue. That's why you can see like there's a green game and there's a blue game. And in the game, I set context. Right, I set the context using the color from this props so that all the elements within this component, for example, the button over here. So game has a controller has button. So button reads this data from the context and sets the color of the button. And one thing you can see here also is that actually in the top of this component, we have the app, which already sets the color, which is already sets the orange color, but then because of context, you can also override whatever is being set in the parent, right? So you just look at the most immediate parents to determine what context color you're getting. So here I'm still I don't use a star because the color itself is determined by the component tree and it's static. I'm not allowing user to change the color, right? This color can be coming from maybe say some configuration files or maybe change of requirements or coming from API. But once you get this data is fixed. You don't change this data by user interaction. Then this can be a very static data. You don't need a store for this. But in our case, we want this data to be local, right? Where you resides determines where what color you're getting. So you are getting using a context to handle it, right? So static means no store, and local means we're going to use a context. Now, last two example. Right now, we have a dynamic and a global component example, right? So this scenario, I have a color picker. So when I come over here, color picker, I change color. You can still pick that on the right? You see that whenever I change, these colors are changing, right? So this, the data itself is dynamic. Although the color wise is global, every buttons, every controller are changing at the same time. So because if it's global, I can define it in the external file. I can define it in a separate file. But because it's dynamic, I'm going to use a store so that I can change the value of the store, and all the components that's using the same store will get reflected immediately, right? Getting the data updated dynamically. Lastly, I have dynamic and locals. So in this case, let's take a look at the example I have. I have three different kind of colors, right? Different components, different buttons are getting a different colors. And they are dynamic. I can change the color anytime I want, right? I change this to be dark green or maybe purple. I can change this to be blue, darker blue. I can change it any color I want, right? So this is dynamic data and local data. So because of its dynamic behavior, I will need a store. And because it's local, I need a context. And therefore, I need to use context to pass down the store. So here you can see that I am now passing down stores, and I'm using the context to pass down store, and I'm using a writable store, right? So this, all these three color picker is changing this value of store, and all the components that is using this store value, it gets updated dynamically, right? And I pass the data through the store, through context. So depends on where my button is, it will be reading from a different context, therefore reading from a different store, and therefore gets a different color updates, right? So this player one color will not be updated if I change the first color picker and vice versa, right? So here you can see four different kind of scenarios by splitting by 2x2 quadrant. Again, static or dynamic, no store or with a store, and global or local, so not using a context or using a context. So I hope this can explain, can answer your question well. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, any more questions, feel free to comment down below. Tell me what is your common scenarios that you like to use, or maybe share some examples that you're using. And why you are using maybe like a store or context or both, right? And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye. Okay.